Hey guys, so I love digital illustration and painting, and as a loyal Photoshop user for years, I want to tell you why I switched to Clip Studio Paint for all of my drawing needs, and why I think you should give it a shot if you're a digital artist. First off, I want to say that I have not been paid by Celsius, the creators of Clip Studio Paint, to make this video. I've just been using this software for years, and I feel like it's been one of the things that has drastically improved my digital art compositions. Now, the title of this video is a little misleading, as I still do use Photoshop in my workflow, and I am not an iOS user. Though I do have access to an iPad with Procreate, and I do think it's a fantastic piece of software with its own set of perks to it, like that little draw a circle and hold it thing where it makes perfect shapes for you. So maybe you'll find that you don't want to abandon your art software entirely, but maybe you'll consider trying this out or adding CSP into your workflow. I don't know. Again, I'm not getting paid to endorse them, so I really don't give a flying foot. Right now, with COVID keeping everyone indoors, I thought it would be a good time to show some of my friends a new art tool, since y'all might have some free time to explore it. Plus, it's super cheap, or even free for 6 months if you're an iPad user, at which point I think it turns into like a super cheap monthly payment thing depending on which version you need. So here we go! My top 11 reasons why I use Clip Studio Paint versus other art software. 1. Stabilization. Yes, most art applications have some sort of stabilizer included with them these days, or you can download external plugins to stabilize your brush strokes. But I think CSP's stabilizer is really flexible. You could really crank this damn soldier boy up if you want to get some crazy smooth lines. For those of y'all unfamiliar with brush stabilizers or stroke correction, I'll explain it in a nutshell. Brush stabilization is pretty much a simple algorithm that runs in the background while you draw that auto-corrects your brush strokes while you're illustrating, usually making the lines that you draw appear slightly behind where your pen is actually on the screen. It's constantly looking at the location that your pen is, and autocorrecting its trajectory to get there. It's kind of like your pen is playing tag with a slow robot that is constantly calculating the best route to get to where your pen is located. In Clip Studio Paint, you could control how fast that robot is, or in other words, how much stabilization you would like to apply to your strokes. So here's an example of me writing the word butt shoes in cursive with the stabilization off and with it on. Now I know that that's a really bad example of what it's doing, but I tried to write the word at the same exact speed that I did the first time. So what you might see there is that it's not great at fast moving things. So let me give you a different example of me slowly tracing the contour lines of my eye with the stabilization on and off. See how this one's really shaky and wiggly while this one is super clean and smooth? That's stabilization at play. Notice the difference. So personally, I find that when I sketch, stabilization just kind of gets in the way 90% of the time. But when I'm inking, it is an absolute godsend. I actually have two keys on this macro keyboard that I just made recently set up to exclusively turn the stabilization of my brushes up and down with how often I use that tool. Spoilers, I'm about to drop a video in the next few days on how to make your own custom macro keyboard for Clip Studio Paint or really any other piece of software that you'd want a custom macro keyboard for, so be on the lookout for that. But this actually brings me to my next reason why I use Clip Studio. 2. Customization. Bruh. This software is super customizable, from how your menus are laid out, to the way that the brushes work, to what each key on your keyboard does when you press it. So you could pretty much make this thing do whatever you want. The reason I'm able to even make this macro keyboard work on iPad, yes, it works on iPad, in theory, is because of your ability to customize all of your shortcut keys. You can even record custom actions and apply them to hotkeys to really do whatever you want to. If you want to change the undo button from Control Z to instead be the 5 key or the M key or Alt Shift number pad 8, you can, and it's really easy to do. For more info on how to do this, be sure to watch my upcoming video on how to make a custom macro keyboard coming out in the next few days. 3. Vector layers. This is a real big one. And first, artists, please don't freak out. If you're anything like me, when you hear the word vector, you might instantly think about your first few times using Adobe Illustrator, a piece of software designed to frustrate the everlasting f*** out of Illustrators. You're not gonna be clicking around on the screen, adjusting anchor points, unless you really want to, just to make art that looks like old Flash webtoons. I'm gonna explain this a little bit more in detail, so buckle up, chuckle f**ks. Clip Studio Paint is a raster-based art software that gives you the ability to use the power of vectors with your raster-based brushes and brush strokes. If what I've said confused the hell out of you, I'm going to attempt to explain what I mean real quick fast. You got two types of images. The kind most of us are used to seeing are raster images, images composed of tiny little square pixels that all make up one big image. Examples being just about any photo you've seen online, or taken with your phone, or the video that you're watching right now. Then you've got vector images, which are instead made up of math! These images, in comparison to raster images, can be blown up to any size without seeing any sort of pixelization, unlike raster images that just look like whale sh** when you try to upscale them. Which might lead you to think, why aren't we always drawing with vectors? And the answer is simple, because normally, you can't do things like this. Except I just did. Like I said, Clip Studio Paint is a raster-based art software that makes vectors our friends. I personally like the results when I sketch my drawings at 300% size and then blow them up bigger. I don't know what it is, it just works for me. Also, the vector eraser tool is absolutely nuts. It analyzes the line that you're trying to erase and will go ahead and erase it all the way to the point where it intersects with another line, which makes sketch cleanup a breeze and gives you the ability to quickly make some really interesting shapes. Working on a vector layer also allows you to use the pinch line tool, which is like a non-destructive version of the liquify effect in Photoshop, letting you correct your lines in a way that doesn't blur them or cause them any harm. Or crank the pinch level up and use this tool to rearrange parts of your drawing to exactly how you see fit. Make sure you tell it to affect the anchor points as well if you don't want it to do this. Something else you can do is simplify your lines to straighten up certain parts of them using the Simplify Line sub tool, or even change the line weight of a drawing at any time you might want to by increasing or decreasing the line width, or even setting the entire width to one specific width.
Dang, dude, vector lines are awesome. What can they do?
Let you use the fill tool, which actually brings me to my next point. 4. The freaking paint bucket is Liddy City. You ever go to fill a shape in Photoshop and have something like this happen? Or even worse, something like this? That freaking line. Real Photoshop nerds know what I'm talking about here. Clip Studio Paint's paint bucket allows you the ability to adjust your fill by a pixel amount to make sure that you never have to expand your selection area or have to click the fill button 3 to 4 times until it fills all the way to your line. It even has a close gap function that will look for areas where you haven't completely connected your lines together and, as the function explains, close the gap for you. Game changer. Reason 5. Brushes. While you now might be blown away at the line creation and fill tool customization that Clip Studio Paint has to offer, I should let you know that the brushes haven't been overlooked either. The brush engine is so crazy and too deep to dive into in this video, and since I spent so much time talking about vector layers, because I love them, I want to speed this up. But if you jump into the brush customization window, you'll see so many options to truly create the brush of your dreams, if you want to. But something I want to plug is the custom brush set from Daub-Brushes, specifically the spatula tool. This guy is my favorite brush of all time. In short, it's a combination between the blend tool and the brush tool, depending on how hard you press. I've only seen a tool like this before in Corel Painter, which I believe is an art software that is way too resource intensive for me to use for the size of images I generally like creating. The spatulas also create a canvas texture, or any texture you want, that I think looks really nice and adds a specific sense of depth to your images that I personally just really enjoy. This is the first digital brush that I've used that I feel truly mimics the way I like to use my acrylic paints in real life. Also, if you've got a Surface Pro model made after the Surface Pro 3, or an iPad made after, I don't know, if your tablet has angle detection, this brush works very similarly to a paintbrush in the way that depending on the angle that you hold your pen to the monitor, it will apply the brush in that same direction. The Daub-Brushes Super Pack is a huge collection of 450 brushes and textures that I guarantee you will find a brush in that you will fall in love with. I really love their Stroke-O-Rator set that comes with it. I feel like it gives a good bit of life to your line drawings. But if you want to check that out, go to Daub-Brushes.com. Wah, wah, wah. There's a link in the description below. All right, on to the next one. 6, layers. Coming from a background in Photoshop, I'm really used to layers being a part of my workflow. I love being able to have everything on separate layers, so if I need to correct a part of my drawing, I can isolate what needs to be fixed and quickly do so without affecting the rest of my artwork. Layers work essentially like a stack of clear overhead projector transparencies stacked on top of each other that you can manipulate how you want. You can even change how they affect each other. If I'm creating anime-style cel-shaded artwork and want to create a shadow on the character's skin, sometimes instead of trying to figure out what color to use, I'll instead use a pale version of pinkish purple or green on a layer above it set to multiply to quickly create a shadow color that I like. Notice how this even creates a good shadow color on things that aren't skin. I like that. I also love using clipping masks, which are basically layers that only affect the parts of the layer directly underneath it that have ink on them. This is great for artists that are bad at coloring inside the lines, or for quickly rendering out shadows on a form. One thing that Clip Studio Paint has that no other art software that I'm familiar with has is located under the layer property window. While it has other layer properties that you might be used to, like adding a stroke around the outside of your layer or changing the layer color, it has the tone effect that quickly creates a screen tone or halftone effect normally seen in manga or in artists like Roy Lichtenstein's work. This effect can easily be edited to affect the dot size or shape or even strength. As a weeb, I love this. This is also a quick and easy way to turn your artwork or photos into a design that can easily be screen printed onto shirts or other things as a one color print design. Look how quickly I can create my own early 2000s hardcore band shirt design with this photo that I got off of Getty Images. 7, colors. There's some really cool things that you could do in Clip Studio Paint with colors. One of them being the Colorize technology preview, which will literally color your artwork for you. It sends your artwork through the internet, compares it to similar images, and colors it accordingly. It's not perfect, but I think that this is absolutely buck wild. You can also use a reference layer to tell it which colors to color with, which can be used to kind of quickly see what your artwork would look like colored, or even generate quick and easy underpaintings that you could then modify to your heart's delight. You can also use gradient maps on your grayscale artwork to quickly add a splash of color to a normally monochromatic image. So cool! 8, animation. You can freaking make cartoons in this bitch. Now, in order to make anything longer than 3 seconds long, or I believe 24 frames, you're gonna have to splurge on the full EX version of Clip Studio Paint. But here's some footage of me quickly creating a really ugly animation of a cat in under 20 minutes. I even created custom macro keys on my keyboard for navigating between and adding keyframes. I find this super handy. I recently used Clip Studio Paint to animate like thousands of frames of animation for my upcoming music video for my song Gay Pock that I also shot and directed myself. Quick little plug, in case you didn't know, I am the greatest and gayest rap artist alive, and I'm about to drop some heat in the next few months. And that's that on that. I did this by importing my video at 12 frames per second and literally drawing directly on top of the video frames. And I have to say that I'm super pleased with the results. 9. Rulers. Clip Studio Paint has the ability to create custom rulers that your pen will automatically snap to and quickly draw in 1, 2, and 3 point perspective, or mirror your images, or crank the amount of lines up and quickly create complex mandala designs in seconds. I feel like this tool is often slept on by many users, but you can really create some awesome effects with it. It's definitely worth playing around with. 10. 3D assets and comic page layouts. So I'm gonna group these two together because I realize that this video is getting really long-winded, but I just really love this software and there's so much that can do. So quickly though, with 3D assets, you can drop in 3D models, pose them in 3D space, and use them as guidelines for things like anatomy and perspective. You can even drop in environments and then convert them to line work and quickly add a background to your lonely characters. Also, if you're into comics, you can even create custom page layouts and drop these 3D assets directly into the frames and not have them affect the other frames. It's crazy. They have so many free 3D assets and textures and brushes is available on the Clip Studio Asset Shop that is almost insanely overwhelming. Spoilers, 99% of them are free, so go ahead and take a look at it. Lastly, it plays well with others. Whether you want to import something that you drew on your phone in Ibis Paint X, or even import or export your image as a Photoshop file, you can do it. As I said at the beginning of this video, Clip Studio Paint is part of my drawing workflow. I love playing with my colors and using my plugins in Photoshop when all is said and done, but all in all, I think that there are so many tools that most people are missing out on by not using it. I know that I'm gonna have comments on this video saying, "That's cheating! These tools are for cheaters! If you can't do that in real life, then you're just not a real artist." To which I simply respond, "Hey, off, buddy." A wise full-time artist friend of mine once told me, "You know, they used to consider the eraser cheating." And that's a really good point. I personally think that we should use the tools that we have available to constantly be pushing the boundaries of our own art and create the best work possible. And if someone wants to tell you that just because your artwork isn't on canvas, that it's not valid, them. Tell me who they are, and I will personally travel to their house and bash their f***ing teeth out for you. Make art, have fun, keep on learning, rinse, repeat, and also don't forget to wash your hands. So that's it! My 11 reasons I think people should take their normal art softwares and shove it right up their assholes. I'm kidding. If you like Procreate or Photoshop or drawing on your Oaxaca boards, there's even still a thing? I hope so. Use it! I'm not trying to dissuade anyone from making art. I'm just trying to show y'all some extra tools that you might not know exist for an often slept upon piece of art software. Hey, so if you like this video, please consider gaping my subscribe button. Really stretch it out. And if you happen to have a friend that works digitally or you think should work digitally, or you're part of an art group on Facebook or Reddit or whatever, please share this video. I'm really working on trying to grow this channel so I can continue to make videos like this one. I can't promise you that they're always going to be art tutorials, but I can promise that you're always gonna get me. And I'm like super cute. So yeah, thanks for watching me rant. Okay, bye!